Presenting next on Contemporary Mosaics, an Ancient Art Revisited, is Amy Marks.
Hi, everybody. I didn't think that I would become a mosaic artist when I was young. I was working as a marketer in software. One day I went out to do some leaf breaking, and I met my next door neighbor, who was a mosaic artist, and I took classes from her. Ancient art, mosaic art is from Greece and Rome, and you can see that if you look at the fish, it's a major focal point. It's outlined with marble or stone or something what we call smalti, and then it usually has a border around it. Originally, the Romans and the Greeks used whatever they found, but then they started creating what is called tesserae, square pieces that they used a hammer and harder to create. Today, we are looking at recycled glass, Murano Millefiore, and stained glass. This is a sample of the hammer and party. Stained glass uses like a pistol cutter, and then we use glass wheel cutters for glass. Andamento is the lines that are created in the background of the piece. This piece is more ancient, and then there were some other pieces there that had sort of helter-skelter. My process is I create a cartoon, which is a drawing, and then I create the final piece. Each piece is hand-cut. I also sometimes use an organic process, where, for example, I had this big chunk of malachite, and I said, well, what can I do with that? And then I took all my green materials and put something together. Lori Micah is an inspiration of mine. She creates her own mosaics made out of polymer clay, and she stamps them, and then she puts them together to create a whole. She also uses image transfer. So what I did is I created this piece. The bush is made out of polymer clay, as well as the crown and part of the tail. And then the rest is glass, shell, beads. This is a more geometric approach, doing what I call mosaic tapestry. The one on the left is organic. It sort of just moves from left to right. And the one on the right has a central piece of fabric. So these are three-dimensional pieces. A bed that's outdoors, a shoe, and a tiger. These are samples of work done by the members of the New England Mosaic Society. Mosaics don't need to be flat. They can bend, they can undulate. And these are two examples of what they could look like. This is the integration of found objects. This one includes driftwood and glass. And the one on the right includes rusted old tools that are put together with natural stones. And you get a really neat effect. This one here is smalti, which is a really thick mosaic tile. And lime, and what she did is she put the leaves on the plaster and then painted them with oil. Realism. Now, I tend to do more abstract. These are just incredible pieces. That one is done with a lot of stained glass. Picasso is using broken ceramics. So creating a storm scene here, and using broken ceramics on the right to create a seed pod. I mentioned smalti, which is a thick piece of glass that is made in either Italy or Mexico. These are some examples of work that's done by that. I'm teaching here at the Fuller Craft Museum, but I believe that the class is full, but I have a class schedule in the back, and so if you're interested in learning how to do some mosaic art, I'd love to have you. I also wanted to let you know about a exhibit that is done by the New England Mosaics Society. It's at the Somerville Museum, and it's free, and I have some of these postcards in the back. Thank you very much.